We are back on the GSMC Chip Shot Football Podcast to get more into these contract talks. Now switching over to the offensive side of the ball and talking about the reigning Super Bowl champions, the Kansas City Chiefs, and getting a big piece of business done. Last night, it was announced that the Chiefs and their center, Creed Humphrey, had agreed to terms on a new four-year, $72 million extension with $50 million guaranteed, going to the former second round pick out of Oklahoma back in 2021. Creed Humphrey gets this massive extension, great for him, but also even better for the Kansas City Chiefs, just because this isn't a first round pick, obviously, second round out of Oklahoma, and that means he doesn't have that fifth year option available to him for the Chiefs to extend these contract talks a little bit further down the line. So this was the year that they had to, you know, get everything together. They had already extended their kicker, Harrison Butker, and they still have a couple more extensions to get through, but this one stood out to me the most just because of that obvious center to quarterback connection, the relationship that Creed has with Patrick Mahomes. So this one was a must-have for the Kansas City Chiefs, and they were able to get it done. But not only that, they were able to make Creed Humphrey the highest-paid center in NFL history, because that new salary, if we do a little bit of math, $72 million by 4 years, about $18 million per year. And that clearly is above the old market value set by the Detroit Lions center, Frank Ragnow, at $13.5 million with $42 million guaranteed that he previously got. Now, Creed Humphrey is clearly above that. And not only of that relationship with Patrick Mahomes did Creed Humphrey definitely deserve this opportunity to get paid accordingly, but also he has earned it, honestly, because he hasn't been in the NFL for too long. In 3 years only in the NFL, he became an immediate starter. You know, he has never missed a start. Every single game of his NFL career that he has had available to him, he's been able to start, 51 games exactly. To his resume, he already has 2 Super Bowls, 2 Pro Bowls, a second team All-Pro back in 2022, and you know, having that all just at the start of your career, he's only going to get better, obviously, with not only how good he is coming out of Oklahoma in the second round on top of that. Yeah, you don't have that fifth-year option available to you, but in the same breath, you get him at that value in the second round, and it made for a great 2021 draft for the Chiefs, honestly, because not only were they able to get Creed Humphrey in the second round, they were able to also draft their starting linebacker, still Nick Bolton, and also in the 6th round of that draft, they were able to select Trey Smith, who is the right guard, if I'm not mistaken, for them still currently right now. And I bring those two guys up, especially in that draft, because not only did they get great value for them and the return that they got for them on the field is fantastic, but they are also due for some contract extensions. Same thing that they were facing with Creed Humphrey. No fifth-year options, obviously, for them, so they are entering the last year of their rookie deals, and those are the two biggest things that the Chiefs need to get done in the meantime now. But getting Creed Humphrey down for the foreseeable future, signed through 2028, is huge, because it makes, you know, the interior part of this offensive line stay together for the foreseeable future. You know, you lock down Creed Humphrey, you have Joe Tooney there as well, and Trey Smith is the final piece of that puzzle. So getting him extended is going to complete everything. And it says a lot, not only that they're able to keep the interior part of this offensive line together, but they've been able to cycle through a couple of tackles in the Patrick Mahomes era, and they've been pretty successful, right, if I were to say. So that's been great for them, keeping a lot of their core players together. And not only were they able to, you know, lock down Patrick Mahomes to that ridiculous 10-year contract or something like that, but they've been able to restructure it a couple times, and, you know, it has opened up these opportunities for these other players to get extended that are massive pieces to what the Chiefs are trying to do now, on the brink of making history, on the verge of three-peating, going back to back to back as Super Bowl champions. But now shifting over to the other players that I mentioned before, that also have to get extended. Trey Smith, the right guard for the Chiefs, and also Nick Bolton, because Creed Humphrey, fantastic. If I were to order it, Creed would have been first to get extended, but now these two are almost as important as Creed Humphrey just because they are entering the last year of their deals, like I said before. And it is funny how it works, having the right guard and the linebacker as your two major extension that you have to get done, just because the salary that has been set for them in terms of the market value is about the same, with $20 million set for both of their markets. I know it's Roquan Smith who makes the most for the inside linebacking position, but also I want to say it's Chris Lindstrom who makes the most for the right guards, and they're both about $20.5 million in salary, and they're the highest earning at their position. So when you talk about Nick Bolton and Trey Smith in each of those markets, I think they can make a push for, you know, getting as close to that market value in terms of, you know, guarantees and things like that. But if I would expect Trey Smith not only to be next, but to potentially make a little bit more than Nick Bolton would, just because in terms of how it's all set out, you have Roquan, and I think you have Fred Warner and Tremaine Edmonds as the highest three earning linebackers, and they're all making, like I said, 20, 19, and like $18 million per year. I don't think the Chiefs are quite there yet with Nick Bolton to want to extend them to that much. And Trey Smith is also another one. I think he could push for 20 to $18 million per year. But in reality, I wouldn't be surprised if both of them agree to anywhere in the range of 15 to $18 million in salary. Just because, of course, every player wants to get paid. Every player wants to get, you know, validated for the work that they put in. And get compensated is the better word to use for what they've been able to do and contribute to this Super Bowl winning team, this dynasty pretty much for the Kansas City Chiefs. But there's also the leverage that the Chiefs have, obviously not only having a lot of success as a team, but when you have Patrick Mahomes and you know what he brings and you know that you always have a chance with him as your quarterback, a lot of players that are lucky enough to be in those positions to have won multiple Super Bowls are not just going to bat an eye and turn their head away from that opportunity to keep winning, especially when you have the best player in football on your team. So that oftentimes works into their advantage when it comes to these contract negotiations. So I wouldn't be surprised that both of them sign maybe a little bit cheaper than we expect, but I wouldn't put it in any category where I'd be worried about these guys getting extended. I feel like it is only a matter of time. They still have a good amount of time also before the start of the regular season. I'm sure Trey Smith and Nick Bolton would want to get it done before then. But locking it down, it always brings up also this other topic of not only Creed Humphrey getting this massive extension, but he joins a good amount of offensive linemen just this year who have gotten also massive extensions themselves. You think of Christian Darrisaw. He is getting paid top-of-the-market money in terms of tackles. Same thing with Tristan Wirfs and Quinn Miners as well for the Denver Broncos, and even Penei Sewell at the start of the offseason. He got extended along with Amon-Ra St. Brown. Penei Sewell was the highest-earning tackle in NFL history just before Tristan Wirfs jumped him in the last month or so when he got his new extension. So, you know, Creed, that makes it five offensive linemen that have gotten contract extensions and pretty decent ones that have reset the market with each of their deals. So it says a lot, I think, not only that there's been five of them, obviously, but the value that the offensive lineman still has in the NFL, right? They might not be the flashiest. A lot of times, fans and teams might not know their names and how much they actually contribute to the success of these teams, but centers, offensive tackles, and even guards in there as well, they play a major part in not only winning, but the identity that these teams want to establish with their organizations. And, you know, Tristan Wirfs, he's won a Super Bowl already. Christian Darrisaw and the Vikings are trying to get there, trying to improve their offensive line. Creed Humphrey, again, multi-time Super Bowl winner. Penei Sewell, conference championship. Quinn Miners, maybe not as successful as those other guys, but he definitely is one of the better players on the Denver Broncos. So, you know, the offensive linemen still hold value. We spend a lot of time talking about the wide receivers, the running backs and how much they're making. We just finished talking about a defensive back and everything like that. So it is important to still highlight the offensive linemen. They do a lot, and a lot of the time their work goes unnoticed. I always say the same thing with offensive linemen. When they're doing a fantastic job, when they're doing everything they're expected to do, you hardly ever hear about them. You might not even know their name. You might not even know where they play on the offensive line. And that's a good thing. That's a good thing because they're not allowing these pass rushers to get in the quarterback's face and getting him injured or anything like that. But when they aren't doing a good job, it stands out like a sore thumb, obviously, because they're always giving up pressures and sacks, and it seems like the quarterback has no time to throw. Don't take it for granted when you have one of these guys and a bunch of other offensive linemen out there that are considered among the best in the NFL. And continuing on with the offensive linemen, you know, you look at a guy like Trent Williams and everything he's been able to do for the 49ers. He's trying to get in on this action as well. Highly considered the best tackle and just overall offensive lineman in the NFL. So it's no surprise that he is holding out, and seeing all these guys get paid, I'm sure he definitely thinks he should be making at least the same or even more than all these guys. And I don't think a lot of people would disagree with him. So that's another situation to keep in mind. And we could have up to 6 offensive linemen get new deals just this offseason, as I do expect the 49ers to get it done with Trent Williams. But for right now, congratulations to Creed Humphrey. The Chiefs were able to draft a great player, but also keep him on their roster for the foreseeable future. And with that being said, we're going to move on to another break here on the show. When we return, 2 new topics to get to just before we close out this show. We're going to be talking about the Patriots quarterback situation again. This time, not Gerard Mayo talking about it, but their offensive coordinator, Alex Van Pelt, and his thoughts on who should be starting and how he's approaching this quarterback battle. And lastly, in the last segment, we're going to be mentioning more on Jahan Dotson, but I'll be giving my rankings on the best NFL wide receiver trios that we currently have after Jahan Dotson forms another one with the Philadelphia Eagles. I'll give you 4 more, and I'll rank them in that last segment. So don't go anywhere. A lot more coming up on today's show. We'll be right back.